To capture the audio output on your computer, first, before you do anything in OBS, you need to double check that it's working properly and it's set up properly. In Windows, you can go down here to the bottom. In Mac, there's a similar setting. Go to your audio icon at the bottom of your desktop, right-click, and go to Sound Settings. It'll pull up this menu, and you can quickly troubleshoot whether you have the right output device selected by going to this drop-down menu right here and selecting the proper output device. But sometimes that doesn't confirm necessarily that you have everything set up properly to output audio from your computer, so you can scroll down this menu and go to your sound control panel, a menu that's hidden in Windows now. Click that, and boom, it'll show you all of the different output devices on your computer that are available. And so what you'll want to do, just to confirm that your output device is outputting at all, go ahead and play a YouTube video. For example, I'm playing a YouTube video, or play a song, or play anything at all on your computer that will give you audio output. And then take a look at your devices here in this list and see if the one that you want to actually output and capture in OBS has some levels. As you can see, mine has some levels right here, my Focusrite USB, but potentially it might not. Or another device may end up having the levels, okay? So what you can do to fix that before you go into OBS is you can actually disable the devices that you don't want to output to, and you can right-click on whichever device you want to be the default device and set it to the default device as well as the default communications device. And that will move everything audio-wise, output-wise, over to the device that you want to capture in OBS. Cool. Now that that's done, now that you confirm that you have levels on the output device that you want to capture in OBS, it's very simple. Go down here to Sources and hit the plus button here to add a new source in OBS. Plus, and go up to Audio Output Capture. So input captures for capturing microphones, capture cards, webcams, whatever. Output capture is to capture whatever your computer is outputting in terms of audio, what you can hear. So go to Focus. I'm going to type in Focusrite Solo because that's the name of mine. Name yours, whatever yours is called, and hit OK. You'll get this property menu where you can select whichever device that you want. I do not recommend selecting default here. I recommend selecting, and by the way, uncheck device timestamps. I don't like that. I recommend manually selecting the device that you want to capture. Mine is a USB device. Yours could be a mixer. Yours could be speakers. Yours could be whatever it is. And once you select the device, you'll start to see the levels here in OBS in your audio mixer, which will confirm that you are now capturing whatever it is that that device is outputting. So if you decide that you want to start a recording or you want to do a live stream over here in OBS, over here on the side, then you will actually be recording whatever is outputted on your computer. So let's say you want to capture a video playback, or let's say you want to capture a live stream, or you want to capture something that has audio that you can play on your computer, such as a YouTube video. This is the way to do it. This is how you capture that output device, and now you can manipulate it in the audio mixer. Look, this is just one of many features in OBS, and it can become quite complicated. I'm happy to help you guys in one-on-one coaching. I'm almost fully booked right now. I have a few sessions left, so if you want to jump in there, you can jump on a one-on-one video call with me. I can help you resolve your technical issues at awalldigital.com. You just literally select your date. Yeah, I only have a couple left on this day. Select your time, input your information, and boom, I'm on a one-on-one call with you, helping you with your YouTube strategy, streaming strategy, or your technical items.